लेक्चर नंबर 4 पॉलीमाइनिंग एपोमिक्सिस चाइमेरा एंड बर्ड स्पोर्ट्स. सो फीस पॉलीएम्ब्रॉयनिंग मींस दैट मोर देन वन एम्ब्रियो डेवलप विद इन अ सिंगल सीड इज कॉल्ड एज पॉलीएम्ब्रॉयनिंग. इट इज आल्सो नोन एज एडवेंटिशियस एम्ब्रॉयनिंग, न्यूसिलर एम्ब्रॉयनिंग और न्यूसिलर बडिंग. सो पॉलीएम्ब्रॉयनिंग मींस सिंगल मोर देन one embryo present in a single seed. Polyembryony can develop from several distinct causes, specific cell in the nucleus or sometimes within integuments have embryos. Genetically, this embryo have the some genotype as a parental plant or apomictic. Adventitious embryo occurs in many plant species and but most common in citrus and mango. In this species, both zygotic and apomictic embryos are produced. In other species, opuntia or no pollination, in this pollination or no pollination is needed. Polyembryony is common in mango and citrus. Species are trifoliate orange. And several seedlings are arise from one seed. Botanical name of this trifoliate orange is the Poinsettias trifoliata. This is a this type of citrus mostly used as this virus resistant plant or this type of species are used for the as a rootstock for the vegetative propagation. And this type of seeds, seedlings are developed from the polyembryony. It's having a resistant variety or the virus-free plants are developed from the polyembryony. Of the seedlings, no seedlings, usually the weakest may be sexual and other arise automatically from the cell in the nucleus which deployed copies of the mother plant. Cells develop, plants develop from the polyembryony as the duplicate copy of mother plant. That means same characteristics are produced in the new plant. Horticultural significance of the polyembryony. This is the advantages of polyembryony. Nucellular seedlings in citrus are completely free from virus. Free from viruses because the embryo sac and adjoining tissue are impregnated at flowering time with some unknown powerful substances which kills all the viruses. Okay, so the nucellular seedlings are completely free from viruses because the reason behind it, the embryos and adjoining tissue are impregnated at flowering time with some unknown powerful substances which kills all the viruses at the time of flowering. The plant produces some unknown substances and that kills all the virus. For immediate requirement, material develop of nucellular lines is the quickest and easiest method. Horticultural applications of polyembryony are nucellular seedlings are 2-type seedlings. That means the seedlings produced from nucellular from polyembryony is 2-type. Such a seedlings are genetically uniform and can be used as a virus-free rootstock. Okay, this is the major advantage of polyembryony. Seedlings are produced are this virus-free rootstock. Okay. More vigorous seedlings, continuous vegetative propagation leads to decline in a vigorous citrus. Vigorous in a citrus. Development of virus-free seedlings and bird food and significance in breeding program. This is the significance or advantages of polyembryony. Next term is the apomixis. Apomixis means embryo developed from diploid cells of the seeds and not as a result of fertilization between ovule and pollen. Okay, embryo developed from the diploid cells of the seeds and no fertilization is required. Okay, this type of reproduction is known as apomixis, and the seedlings produced from this manner is called as apomictic. Okay, apomixed seedlings. Reproduction is known as apomixis, and this type of seedlings are produced from this manner is called as apomix. Apomictic seedlings are identical to mother plants and similar to plant raised by other vegetative means because of such plants genetic makeup as that of the mother plant. Okay, so through the seedling we produce the same identical mother plants, and in the vegetative propagation some genetical makeup are observed in a new arise plants. Such as seedlings are completely free from viruses and the plant produce only apomixed embryo and known as obligate apomix. And those which produce both apomix and sexual seedlings are called as facultative apomix. Okay. So there are two terms. First is obligate apomix and second one is the facultative apomix. First one is the embryo or the plant produce only apomix embryo. Okay, plants produce only apomictic embryo is called as obligate apomix, and the plants produce both apomictic and sexual seedlings is called as facultative apomix. Types of apomixes, there are classified into four groups. First one is the recurrent apomixes. In this type of apomixes, embryo develop from diploid egg cells from the diploid or from the diploid cells of embryo sac without fertilization. First, recurrent apomixes, that means the embryo develop from diploid egg cell and or the diploid cells of embryo sac without fertilization. As a result of egg has normal diploid number of chromosomes just like mother plant, these species where recurrent apomixes commonly occur in Parthenium, Rubus, Malus, Allium, then Rudbeckia, Poa and Taraxacum. So recurrent apomixis means embryo develop from diploid egg cells of the embryo sac and no fertilization is required. And non-recurrent apomixis, that means diploid haploid egg cells and diploid egg cells. Diploid, that means the two cells, and haploid, that means the single cells. In a recurrent apomixis, embryo develop either from haploid egg cells or from some other haploid cells of embryo sac. In this case, haploid plants are produced which contain only one set of chromosome of mother plant. Hence, haploid plants are sterile in nature and cannot normally perpetuate into the next generation. This is non-recurrent apomixis. In this case, haploid egg cells of embryo sac, embryo develop from haploid egg cells of embryo sac. But
ma'am,
hello,
ma'am, sabre apomixis hai virus free asil na.
Non-recurrent apomixis. In this case, haploid egg cells, haploid, that means a single cell, single egg cells are used for the development of embryo. Okay, but in this case, haploid plants are produced which contain only one set of chromosome of mother plant. Only a single set of chromosomes are carried in the mother plant. And the haploid plants are sterile in nature. Sterile, that means they cannot normally perpetuate in the next generation. Then they cannot produce a next generation. So that's why it is called as non-recurrent apomixis. Occurs only, and this is occurs only a few species such as Solanum nigrum or Lilium species. Then mucilar embryony or adventitious embryony. In this type of apomixis, the embryo arises from a diploid sporophytic cells outside of the embryo, that is the cell of mucilus integument. This type of apomixis is a quite common in the citrus of, and the certain varieties of mango, where the fertilization occurs normally and sexual plus a number of apomixis seedlings or the mucilus embryos develop. Mucilus embryo or adventitious embryo. In this case, embryo developed from diploid sporophyte cells outside of embryo sac. So the structure of seed is there are different parts in the structure of seeds. Mucilar embryony, sporophytic cells, then embryo sacs, egg cells, diploid and haploid egg cells. Angiosperm, etc. Okay, so in this case, the embryo developed from arise from the diploid sporophytic cells outside embryo, that is mucilage of integuments. Also, one part of seed structures integuments, and this type of apomixis is a quite common in citrus. In this case, a quite fertilization occurs normally, and sexual plus a number of that means the both apomictic and the sexual fertilization are occurring. Then vegetative apomixis. In this case, some species of the plants such as Allium, Agave, Poa, etc. The flowers in the inflorescence are replaced by bulbs. Okay. So in this case, sometimes the flower inflorescences are replaced by bulbs. That means the inflorescences are replaced by bulbs. This is the example of Agave or Allium species, or the vegetative buds which sprouts while still of the mother plant are turned into a new daughter plants. That the bulbs or the vegetative buds which sprouts and produce new daughter plants. Okay. Advantages of apomixis is assured reproduction in absence of pollinators such as the extreme environments. Then maternal energy not washed in unfit offspring. Okay. So this is the advantages. All the characters are carried out in the offspring. Offspring, that means the new generation, new plant. Then some apomixis plants, not all, avoid a male energy cost of producing pollen. Disadvantages: can't control accumulation of deleterious genetic mutation. Sometimes the genetic mutation may be occur. Some genes are deleted from this process. Then use restricted to narrow ecological niches. Lack ability to adapt changing environment. Okay, some plants cannot be accumulate or the adapt in a different changing environment. It requires some specific environment for the production for the growth of the plant. This is the advantages. Then clone. The term clone may be defined as a group of genetically uniform individual derived originally from sexually produced individual, or from mutation, or maintained exclusively by sexual means from the one ancestor. Clone, that means the genetically uniform individual developed or derived originally from sexual produce. Okay, this is called as clone. The common examples are Bartlett pear, delicious apple, Sultan grapes, and the sherry mango. This is the examples of clone. That means the variety developed from clone, same identical or some genetically uniform plants are produced from this clone. The goal of vegetative propagation is to reproduce progeny plants identically in a genotype to a single plant. The biological process is known as cloning, and the resulting population of the plant is called as clone. Okay, so genetically similar plants are produced from the mother plant. The uniform or individual plants within a clonal population is a major advantage of clonal cultivars of fruits and nut crops. Uniformity of individual plants within a clonal population. This is the major advantages of clonal cultivars of fruit and nut crops. So the clone, in a single word, uniform produced from the mother plant. Then clonal population, clonal propagation helps in fixing genotypes, uniformity of population, facilitate propagation, reduce juvenile phase, from more than one genotype to a single plant, grafting or control phase of development. In a clonal propagation, we have to fix genotypes, uniformity in a population, and reduce the juvenile phase. That means reduce the life cycle of the plant. Juvenile phase, and that means some plants are bearing very early in the age, 2 to 3 years after the planting. Reduce the clonal plant can reduce the juvenile phase of the plant. Then combine more than one genotype in a single plant by grafting, etc. Okay, so this is the advantages. If the environmental condition are favorable and clone is managed properly, its trueness to tribe can be maintained for 100 of years. Through this propagation, we can manage properly trueness in the plant and can be maintained hundreds of years. Then genetic variation in a clone. First is the mutation. Mutation means a sudden heritable change within a cell of clones. The single genetic, okay, this is called mutation. In general, the change takes place spontaneously in the plants, regular but rare intervals. Some genetical changes are occurring in a plant or the clone is called as mutation. The changes may be spontaneously, means quick changes can be occur, or sometimes rarely. Okay. The mutation is a genetic change involving some parts of the DNA molecules. The genetic changes can be occur in DNA molecule, and mutation results from structural changes in nuclear DNA of the chromosome in the nucleus. So the genetic changes of the genetic mutation results from structural changes. DNA also occurs in mitochondria, chloroplast, and defect cell can be produced genetic changes. So DNA are occurs in mitochondria and chloroplast also. So the defect can be produce a genetic change. Chromosomal changes may be due to the chance rearrangement of the four base. Based in the DNA molecule, point mutation, rearrangement of different plants of the chromosome, that is deletion, duplication, translocation, and inversion. Addition of or the subtraction of individual chromosome is aneuploidy. This is the aneuploidy. That means subtraction or the addition of chromosome. It is called as aneuploidy. Or the multiplication of entire sets of chromosome is polyploidy. Okay, some species are polyploidy in nature and some species having the aneuploidy in nature. At the time of genetic process, some chromosomes may be depleted or subtracted. So haploid cells or the single chromosome, okay, this is called as aneuploidy, and polyploidy, that means the number of chromosomes, okay, sets of chromosome. The rate of mutation can be increased by treatment with a specific mutagenic agent, X-ray, gamma rays, and certain chemicals. Rate of mutation, for the increasing rate of mutation, the treatment due with a specific mutagenic agents like X-ray, gamma ray, and certain. The next one is bird spots or bird mutation. The mutation occurs and suddenly appears as the chance in the branch of plant is called as bird spots or bird mutation. The mutation can be occur in any place of the plant. Sometimes can be occurring in mitochondria and chloroplast, but sometimes can occur in the branch of the plant. It's called as bud spores. Okay, because they appear have originated within a single bud. Detection of new mutant gene of load may require a series of repetitive propagation generation and multiple propagation from many parts of the same plant. Mutation can be within a clone may require a series of repetitive propagation and multiple propagation from many birds of the same plant. There are many spores. Structures of the plant. Sometimes there can be offer effects on the color of the plant, maturity of the plant, then structures of the plant, time of bloom, etc. Sometimes the mutants have highly useful horticultural traits and have given rise to important new cultivars. Ruby red garden and grapefruit. Red color spots of apple and pears. On other hand, mutation may be undesirable and to rise to this shape to low production and susceptibility. So, mutation can affect mutation can be harmful to the plant and sometimes can be painful to the plant. So sometimes due to mutation, some undesirable or the misfit plants and fruits can be grown from the plant, and sometimes low production can be grown from the plants, and then sometimes some varieties are susceptible to specific disease. This is the mutation. Okay. Then genera. When the mutation occurs within a single cell of clone, it is initially produced in isolates of mutant cells within a growing points of state. In this term, the mutation occurs in a growing point of state. It becomes a mixture of two different genotypes. Structural arrangements are known as the chimera. So, standard, that means the mutation occurs in the single phase of chromosome or the mutant cell within the growing point of state. It is the most important kind of genetic variant. It is modified by various kinds of variation. The name Chimera is historically given to a certain unique clonal variant, known to have because of the transportation of the apical nerve cells and the specific location of the mutations in a dividing cell near the apex of the apical nerve. Cannula usually occur in the apical nerve stem of the plant. Apex. The three types of cannula are based on the distribution of patterns of and non-mutant cells. Birds arising at a different position on sectorial cannula may be to the specific of mutant and non-mutant cells in that of mutant cells are entirely cells are entirely of non-mutant cells. A sectorial reaction very famous cannula that is like first. Pericles cannula. The mutant tissues occupy layer of cells that completely surrounds the inner core of the non-mutant tissue. For example, many red color fruit cultivars in apple, red pigments is located only in the epidermal layer where the cell of the inner tissue have allele for gene or yellow color. Some black leaves cultivars are formless because the cells mating up with the into perennial mating stable in propagated stem graft. So this is the type of perennial cannula. That means the tissue occupy the layers of the cell that completely surrounds the inner core of the non-mutant tissue. Sometimes the red cultivar, the red fruit cultivar, natural, the red fruit is located only in the epidermal layer. That means that the location of the cannula is only in the specific space. For that, red fruit is the cannula. And based on the cannula, the population is that the cell has a certain part of outer layer. That is, each medicine cannula, even where the nuclear part is the inner layer and the outer layer. On the yellow direction, the population may have a longitudinal of the red. Sectorial cannula, the mutated cells in this combination occupy in the entire sexes of the stem, including all layers of the shoot apex. Sectorial chimeras appear if the mutation occurs in the root and a very early stage of the embryos, whereas the cells of the growing point do not occur in layers. In general, this type is unstable and tends to convert into mariclinar or periclinar chimeras. In this case, the chimeras occur in the root surface. Okay. Then graft chimeras. In horticulture, the graft chimeras may arise in a grafting at the point of contact between rootstock and scion. And will have properties intermediate to those of parents. A graft chimera is not a true hybrid, but a mixture of cells, each with the genotypes of one of its parents, is a chimera. Hence, the once widely used term graft hybrids is not descriptive. It is now proving, you know, from upon the practice, graft chimeras are not noted for their stability and easily revert back to the one of these parents. So graft chimera, that means it's graft chimeras may be arise grafting at the point of contact between rootstock and spine. The portion of chimeras, graft chimeras, is the rootstock and spine portion, and this is the intermediate parents. Okay, the properties is the intermediate parents. Some properties carried out from the mother rootstock portion, and some of the from spine portion. The graft chimeras is not true hybrids, but a mixture of cell of each genotypes of one parent. Okay, this is not true hybrids. Okay, some characters are carried out from the mother plant and some from, that means the some from scion and some from rootstock. Hence, once widely used term graft hybrid, and it is not descriptive. It is now frowned upon. The practice chimera is not noted for their stability. So the stability of graft chimera is not stable. It can be reverted back to the one of this parent. Sometimes the character may be occurred only from the rootstock portion, and sometimes from the only scion portion. So this is all about polyembryony, apomixis, clone, and chimeras, etc. Okay.